Good afternoon, dear participants of the conference. My name is Vladimir Miroshnichenko. I am from Institute of Marine Sciences, Middle East Technical University, Turkey. And I will present the MARMOD database, the database which contains Marmara Sea marine data. The MARMOD, it's a abbreviation for a project. MAR stands for Marmara, and MODIS stands for modeling. And full title of the project is an integrated modeling system for the Marmara Sea. The funding agency is the Ministry of Environment and Urbanization of Turkey. The coordinators of project, there were two coordinators, Institute of Marine Sciences and Laboratory Measurement and Monitoring Department of the Ministry. And also participants were Institute of Marine Sciences and Management, Istanbul University, Marmara Research Center of Turkish Scientific Council, and Institute of Marine Sciences and Technology of Dokuzeli University, Izmir. The ultimate goal of the project is to create an integrated modeling system that will be used in the development of water quality improvement plans with environmental management and ecological approach specific to the Marmara Sea. And specific objectives is to create integrated database of the Marmara Sea for the first time and apply a coupled hydrodynamic biogeochemical model to identify and predict effects of the Black Sea urbanization, agriculture, and industry on the environmental health of the Marmara Sea. The area of research. This is so-called Turkish Strait system, which connects two seas, Black Sea and Aegean Sea, consists of two straits, the Bosphorus Strait, or in Turkish it's called Istanbul Strait, the Marmara Sea itself, and Dardanelles, in Turkish Çanakkale Strait. This is persistent two-layer structure. In upper layer, light and less saline waters from Black Sea follow through Bosphorus, Marmara Sea, and Dardanelles to Aegean Sea, and more dense and saline waters from Aegean Sea follow in opposite direction to Black Sea. And those two layers are divided by very sharp picnic line. The objectives for the database were to provide environmental data for setting up the hydrodynamic biogeochemical model. The main data suppliers are Institute of Marine Sciences, which submitted 75% of data to this database. And IMS METU is performing research in Marmara Sea, starting from middle of 80s of last century. Since that time, it was conducted more than 200 cruises, and physical, chemical, and biological data were collected at about 7,000 stations. And this data are complemented by environmental data from the Ministry of Environment and Urbanization, from the monitoring program, which ministry started in 2000s and continues till now with the help of several subcontractors like MST and Tubitak MAM. The database essentially is the ocean data view collection, which contains data from 273 cruises, more than 9,000 stations on 18 parameters with more than 1 million values for time period of from 1985 till 2017. The spatial distribution shows that it's irregular. The most intensive measurements were done in Bosphorus area, while other parts of the Marmara Sea are covered irregularly. Temporal distribution shows that most intensive investigations were done in decade from 1985 to 1995, and then research were not so intensive. As for seasonal histogram, it shows that data are distributed along the year more or less evenly. This is table shows statistic per parameter, total 18 parameters. The most measurements are done for temperature and salinity, followed by nitrates, phosphates, other nutrients, then oxygen, and some other CTD parameters. The quality control of data was performed with the help of ODV, following the procedures elaborated by C.NET project. 97% of data are flagged as good, so not for every parameter this percentage is equal. From data, some finding from data, the oxygen depletion in deeper waters. As you can see, till 2005, the oxygen concentration in deep waters of the Marmara Sea was above 50 micromoles. But then it started sharply to decrease, which may say that it's going to depletion. The data from the database were used for initialization and verification of the model. On this slide, you can see the seasonal profiles calculated for temperature, salinity, nitrates, phosphates, oxygen, and also this were calculated for other parameters. The model was run for 9 different scenarios, and some selected results from the model are as follows. Basin-borne nutrients loads at least 2 times exceed loads from the Black Sea. If the Black Sea loads would be fully eliminated, the Marmara Sea deep waters could recover from hypoxia in 7-8 years. But if the terrestrial loads would be reduced only by 40%, the hypoxia in deep waters could be recovered in 6 years. So reducing of terrestrial loads is priority measure. The future plans for the database. It's planned to fulfill it with new data from external sources, from continuing regular monitoring, and from new transects that will be added to the monitoring program for investigating pollution propagation. Also, the MARMOT database contains a lot of data. The biogeochemical models require more dense data on regular grid. Therefore, within the second phase of the MARMOT project, new data will be acquired in 4 seasonal cruises on a regular grid, including data from underway instruments such as SCANFISH, ADCP, thermosalinograph, and fluorometer. Acknowledgement. We acknowledge Ministry of Environment. We acknowledge DECOSIM, the Marine Environment Ecosystem and Climate Research Center at IMS METU, and NASA ESD's project for usage of satellite imagery for this presentation. And thank you for your attention.